But I do want us to turn to Psalm 139 if you're not there already. So I think about Psalm 139. This is a rich psalm that shows that God delivers from evil men. You know, do you ever run into folks that are just really contrary? They're ungodly. They really slander you. They bring it up before the union, the management, or they take your name to HR and complain about you. What do you do when people are unethical and they lie? Now, I know some of those things might be partially true, but they're laced with a whole bunch of slander. What do you do in those scenarios? And today, as I think about that, Psalm 140, verse 1 through 4. Deliver me, O Lord, from evil men. Preserve me from violent men who plan evil things in their hearts, who continually gather together for war. They sharpen their tongues like a serpent, and the poison of asp is under their lips, Selah. Keep me, O Lord, from the hands of the wicked. Preserve me from violent men who have purposed to make my steps to stumble. Here we come into this passage, and verse 1, we see David. How does he respond? He asks God, God, would you rescue me? The Hebrew word here is to preserve, to keep. God, would you guard me? Would you guard me from these evil men? Verse 4, we see, God, will you keep and preserve me while these men are ruthless? They're careless about me. Here he's saying, God, I know you care when men are careless. God, would you preserve me? And notice how David trusts over in 6 and 7. We didn't read that. But I said to the Lord, you are my God. Hear the voice of my supplications, O Lord. O God, the Lord, the strength of my salvation. You have covered my head in the day of battle. Here, David's like, God, I come to you as my God. I come to you as my rescuer, my deliverer, as the one who covers me and keeps me. You know, as we think about this, the world around us may try to trip us up at times. And we realize sin is always a choice, and there's always a temptation for people to do wrong. And yet, for the obstinate sinner is to be, while he may be unrelenting, unscrupulous in his goal to indulge in mean-spirited things, verse 6 we see, God, you hear. You care when others are careless. And we come before you and say, God, you are good. And notice even in verse 8 how that David continues to pray with confidence. God, do not grant, O Lord, the desires of the wicked. Do not further this wicked scheme, lest they be exalted, Selah. God, this will take away from you getting glory. This will be all another riot, ugly thing, blow up. God, it just steals away from you. God, would you please protect me? Would you please guide in this? Would you please care in all of this? Now, verse 7, we see, you are the strength of my salvation. This is the Hebrew word Yeshua, which is the name we know, the Hebrew name for Jesus. The Lord saves. God, you are the one who saves, who rescues. Now, you and I know that there's an aspect where Jesus saves us from sins, but he also saves us from destruction and gives us deliverance. And here today, we want to thank God. Thank you that you're a God who delivers us from evil men. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we come before you and we worship you that your Son has done everything to deliver us from the power of sin, from the penalty of sin by dying on the cross and rising again. Lord, we also come before you and say, Lord, we need daily protection. Lord, this world is just passing away, and we just have a temporary assignment here. But Lord, while we're on this earth, would you please help us to live for eternity, trusting you with the outcome of even evil men? Help us, like David, to turn to you and say, Lord, you are the strength of my salvation. God, you're where it's at. We love you and we praise you. Give us strength, Lord. May you be praised. In Jesus' name, amen.